Hey learners, it's Miss Chris here. Do you like reptiles? Well, I hope so, because today we are learning all about Komodo dragons, iguanas, alligators, crocodiles, and so much more. So please tune in as we go on a fun reptile adventure. All right, friends, follow me. First up is one of the biggest, baddest animals, we have the Komodo dragon. And for this, we've got to hop all the way over to a little place called Indonesia. If you see, it's south of the Philippines and north of Australia. So let's hop over to these beautiful islands and whoa, look at that big guy. Oh my gosh, look at his big mouth. Okay, let's learn all about what this Komodo dragon can do. These are the biggest and heaviest lizards on Earth. They live on Komodo Island and a few neighboring islands of the Lesser Sunda Islands of Indonesia. Full-grown Komodo dragons can reach 10 feet long and weigh more than 300 pounds. Wow! The average Komodo dragon is about 150 pounds. So 300 is a bit extreme. The average is 150, but still, can you imagine one being up to 300 pounds? That is a huge lizard. Okay. They are the dominant predators where they live on Komodo Island. They will eat almost anything. They can eat deer, water buffalo, pigs, and they would even eat a human if they saw one. Keep me away from Komodo Island. Oh, let's see what this one's doing. That is a big animal, huh? All right, that one's just walking around. Oh, here we are cruising around Komodo Island. It sure looks beautiful. Wow, look at this Komodo dragon. It looks like he has a purple tongue. Oh, wow. Oh, he's on the move. All right. So they are the dominant predators. They will eat almost anything, and their saliva contains large amounts of harmful bacteria. So even if their prey escapes, their saliva poisons their prey. So the Komodo dragon stalks it ever so patiently and then can find their prey. All right, I've seen enough of this scary predator. Let's find another reptile. What do we have here? Do you know what it is? If you said tortoise, you are correct. So to see these beautiful Galapagos tortoises, we have to cruise all the way to Ecuador, which is a country in South America, Northwest South America. The word Ecuador actually means equator in Spanish. Let's check out some of these cool tortoises. Oh, this is a little itty bitty one. Look how cute it is. Get out of the way so you can see it. All right, so this is one when it's very small, but let's try to find a huge one because they sure do get big. Whoa, look at this one. So there are many different species of tortoises, and they can live to be over 100 years old. They can weigh over 500 pounds and be up to 6 feet long. All right, let's see what he likes to eat. Oh, look at this one chomping down on some fruits and veggies. So this tortoise, like all reptiles, is covered in scales. See how its arms have those scales for protection? And it also has this shell on the top on its back, just like a Ninja Turtle, and it will have a shell on its belly. The top of the shell, that top shell of the tortoise, is called a carapace, and then the shell that covers the belly is called a plastron. Now, why do you think these tortoises need those shells? It's because the other parts of the tortoise are very soft. So what do you think happens when he tucks himself in there? Yeah, that's right. He's protected and safe because of the hard shell on the back and the hard shell on his belly. All his softer pieces are nice and safe and protected. All right, now we are going through some marsh water. What type of reptile do you think we might find out here in this brackish, murky marsh water? If you said an alligator, you are correct. All right, we'll be talking mostly about the American alligator today, but there are a few different types. But let's talk about our friend, the American alligator. They can live up to 50 years old. The average is about 35 years old. And they can be from 10 feet to 15 feet long and weigh up to 1,000 pounds. That is a large alligator. Let's see if we can find some more.
Wow.
They use that big, strong tail to help propel them through the water, and they even have webbing on their toes to make them excellent swimmers. Oh, look at that one just strutting along the street. Oh my goodness, look at this huge group of them. So they mostly live in the southeastern United States. So we're talking Florida, southeastern Texas, and Louisiana. They live in rivers, lakes, ponds, marshes. And this is a fact that I learned while I was doing my research for this. As their teeth get worn down, they get more and more, so they never run out of teeth. So they can go through up to 3,000 teeth in their lifetime. Isn't that incredible? Let's see, got one more of these big groups of alligators. Whoa, that's a ton of gators. They're actually very intelligent creatures. Alligators have been observed to do things like hold sticks while underwater to try to trick birds into landing on them or capturing them for nesting supplies and then capturing the birds as their prey. That's very smart. And although alligators do not have vocal cords, they've been observed to use some types of calls to communicate with other alligators. And they never stop growing. They just keep getting bigger and bigger and bigger. And their stomach can dissolve anything, even bone, so they have no need to eat around bones of their prey. They just gobble the whole thing up. And they eat more than just meat. They're even known to enjoy things like fruits, berries, etc. All right, you might be thinking, you know, they look so much like crocodiles. How do we tell the difference between alligators and crocodiles? Well, lucky for you, I am here. And I made this for us. So they do look similar, but there are ways to tell alligators and crocodiles apart. So let's look at their snout first. You see, the alligator has this rounded snout. And then if we come over here and look at the crocodile, it has more of a narrow, pointier snout. Now, let's look at the teeth. I can't see too many of the alligator's teeth when its mouth is closed. Oh, it's teeth galore over here. Look at all these teeth that we can see. So those are two big differences. Also, we can talk about their habitats. Alligators are usually in freshwater, and crocodiles, although sometimes in freshwater, they're often in saltwater, also rivers, lakes, wetlands, and some brackish water. How about where do they live? Like we said earlier, alligators are in parts of the U.S., and there is a Chinese alligator that's in China. But we're not talking about that one today. We were talking about the American alligator. But the crocodile lives in Africa, Asia, and Australia. So, if you ever are confused, just think about, can I see their teeth? No? It's probably an alligator. If I can see a ton, then it's the crocodile. And also the shape of the snout. Long and narrow, you've got a crocodile. Wider and a little shorter, you've got a gator. All right, let's see if we can find some more gators. Oh yeah, look at all those teeth. That's definitely a crocodile. I said, let's see if we can find more gators. I meant crocodiles. Oh, look at all of those scales. Definitely a reptile. It's covered in scales. Ooh, this crocodile looks like it's ready to eat. Let's see if they're gonna get any food. Hungry. We can see all those teeth along the sides, so we know they're crocodiles. And they've got those narrower snouts. Oh, it looks like feeding time, maybe at the zoo, but they look like they might be in captivity here and someone is feeding them something on a rope. Oh, is he gonna get it? Is he gonna get it? Oh man, he almost had it. Come on, mister, you can do it. Oh, Oh, I think he got it. Nope. Oh, there we go. You go, buddy. You got it. Oh my goodness, another feeding frenzy. Another feeding frenzy. Look at those crocodiles go. All right. They are expert swimmers who move very quickly in the water. Now, it wouldn't be an episode about reptiles if we didn't talk about snakes. So we have two big kahunas that we're going to mention today. The first one is the reticulated python. Now, the reticulated python is the longest snake in the world, but the green anaconda is the largest snake when we consider both weight and length. All right, so we're going to talk about this green anaconda first. It can reach up to 30 feet in length and weigh up to 550 pounds. Ooh, that's a lot. So anacondas are part of the constrictor family, like a boa constrictor, pythons. Ooh, look at that spooky face. Ooh. So the way these constrictors work is that they don't use venom. What they do is squeeze tighter and tighter and tighter. Get ready for a video that's a little spooky. Ooh. So here is an example of a snake that has found some prey and then wrapped itself around and is constricting it until the prey says, "Ooh, you know what, I can't even breathe anymore, so yeah, I'm gonna lose this one." And you can see the snake has unhinged its jaw and is eating that animal whole. And then it will digest the entire thing. Its digestive juices will just kind of melt it down and it will digest it. There are only a few parts that the snake cannot digest, and that's things like fur, hair, and claws. And well, you can guess what happens to those things. Mm-hmm. So, but other than that, the snake can digest everything. All right, so that covers our snakes. Why don't we go to something a little more wholesome? All right, for this, we'll have to cruise to a beach because up next is our iguana. Let's find a fun looking iguana. Oh, I think I see one over here. Look at that beautiful creature. Oh man, have any of you ever seen an iguana out and about at the beach or when you were on vacation somewhere hot? They can be really beautiful colors. They love to lounge around in the sun. Let's find another one. Oh, wow. Look at this one. All right, let's find some iguana fun facts for y'all. They, of course, belong to the reptile family. That's why we're chatting about them today. And they are often seen sunning themselves in the Americas. That's where they reside. They eat leaves, fruits, insects. Ooh, and even small mammals and birds. There are some marine iguanas that live in the Galapagos and they eat seaweed. Males change their colors to impress females and they can even become a bright orange. They have excellent vision and can see distances, shapes, shadows, color, and movement. An iguana uses its eyes to navigate through trees, forests, as well as for finding food. See. I think iguanas are the ones who are good swimmers. Yes, they are. Let's find a video of this iguana swimming. Oh, look at that. Did you know that iguanas can swim? Sometimes if they feel threatened while they're up lounging on a tree, they might say, "Oh, I'm just going to get out of here." Blunk. And they'll jump into the water from many feet in the air. So there's that iguana swimming. Oh, here's one more. Maybe this is a male trying to impress a female. And that's why he's bright orange like that. Look at those beautiful, beautiful colors. All right, we have one reptile left to talk about. But for this one, we're going to have to go into the jungle or rainforest. All right, let's go. We are looking for our friend, the chameleon. I see one. It's up there. All right, let's go. Whoa, look at those cool colors on the chameleon. So these are types of lizards famous for being able to change the color of their skin. They live in Africa, Asia, and Europe. Let's see if we can find a more colorful one. Oh, he's getting ready to eat something. Oh, did you see it catch that insect? Let's watch, it'll do it again. Okay, he's gonna shoot his tongue out a long distance and catch an insect. Let's see. Oh, Mr. Chameleon, you can do it. Here he goes. Oh, wow, that was so cool. Okay, let's see if we can find another chameleon. Ooh, look at the colors on this one. How beautiful. Most of them live in trees, like we said earlier. Their toes are divided into two groups to help them grasp the branches and make them really great climbers. Oh, we've got to find one with those toes. Aha! Can you see the toes, how they're separated like that? That's how he is such a great climber. Wow, look at those little chameleon toes. All right, let's keep finding more chameleons. Whoa, look at the colors on this one. They range in length from 1.5 inches to 24 inches, and most chameleons are about 7 to 10 inches. They change color, not like we all think, because of they want to blend into the surroundings, but because they might be scared, or they want to communicate with others, or even because they're angry. But how? How do they change color? Great question. Because they have special cells under their skin, and inside these cells, color particles move around, and the chameleon takes on the color of whichever particles are packed together most closely. Green, yellow, and dark brown are the most common chameleon colors. But as you can see, there are some really cool chameleon colors. Look at this one! A bright electric blue. How gorgeous! Do you have any other chameleon fun facts for you? So like most lizards, chameleons eat insects. They use their long sticky tongues, like we saw earlier, to catch prey. And larger chameleons even eat young birds. Wow. All right, friends, that was all of our reptiles for today. I hope you enjoyed learning about our tortoises, our Komodo dragons, our alligators, our iguanas, our chameleons. I had so much fun, so don't forget to subscribe if you had fun too, and I'll see you next time.